Ron Alexander TV show. And thank you for making me the number one independent TV host show in, I ain't gonna say the country, but like St. New York City right now, where we go all over the place and we get, oh man, it just go back to Boogie Down Production, it go back to the KRS-One, these people that have been on this show, African Bambaataa, Planet Rock, so, which is still, that 12 intro is, you know, so like 10 million copies and stuff like that. Pretty Ricky, Platinum, 2 Gold Record, and they told me that record wouldn't work. Grind With Me, when I heard it, oh, good Rachel. But we were in Chicago at that particular time, but Vaughn Mason, Bounce Rock and Skate, 5 million copies and all that. Now these are vinyls, what we're doing here, they're not doing vinyls right now, they're coming back, but you're doing more of going to internet and whatever. But let me tell you one thing, get off your ass, get outside, go down and visit some of these record labels, okay? You're not gonna get signed like that, okay? You got a CD, if it's hot, I know people bring me down, hot CD. Make 500, 700, 800 of them and sell them when you on tour. And like when you coming down here, sell the damn CD so you can pay your rent. And stop giving away free stuff.
Sure.
Rich people don't give away free stuff. That's why they rich. But, and wow, it's just so much happening. Chuck Berry passed away, 90 years old.
Yeah.
And, I know. Yeah, he's older than me, but he goes back, the founding father of rock and roll.
Yeah.
Okay? The founding father of rock and roll. It wasn't Elvis Presley.
Educated, properly made it, jumping, get it on the wall. Gotta get it, bouncing, get it, got me time to set it all. Educated, properly made it, jumping, get it on the wall. Gotta get it, bouncing, get it, got me time to set it all. I've been gone for a while, I took some time off. Went through some things, now I'm back. Now I'm ready to set it off. Ain't got no time for no people that wanna play games. Gotta make this thing work out, people, if you hear me say. Get it popping, get it jumping, get it off the wall. Gotta get it bouncing, get it rocking, time to set it off. About to get it popping, get it jumping, get it off the wall. Gotta get it bouncing, get it rocking, time to set it off. I'm focused and I got this unlocked. Got my mind on trying to make it to the top. Couldn't take the stress, but now it's a breeze. I'm that young, hot R&B singer stepping onto the scene. About to get it popping, get it jumping, get it off the wall. Gotta get it bouncing, get it rocking, time to set it off. About to get it popping, get it jumping, get it off the wall. Gotta get it bouncing, get it rocking, time to set it off.
Let's go. testimony, or I take my test and turn it into a testimony, ultimately. And I say it's one of those things where it's made me stronger. It's definitely, I feel like I'm in better shape, better health than I've ever been before, because it's allowed me to pay attention and focus more on my health, and I'm making that a number one priority. And at the same time, say I have lupus, but lupus doesn't have me. So I'm one of those people that want to wave the flag and say, hey, you can win this fight. Advice that I would give to anyone with this condition would be just to take it one day at a time. Some days are harder than others, but just to persevere, fight through it, and make sure you do everything that your doctor tells you to do. There's many things that I would love for people to know and understand about lupus, but ultimately, like, that it's not over when you hear it, when you know someone who has it. It's something that, you know, you can definitely get through, and you can win with any condition when you hear it, when you're not knowledgeable of it. Not only yourself, but the people around you can get filled with fear. But it's probably more, the more you know about it, the more you can understand it, and the more that those fears go away. It's important to spread awareness about lupus for a few reasons. I mean, mainly, you know, the more awareness, then the more people are familiar with the disease. And a lot of the misconceptions about lupus can be cleared up. But then even more importantly, when you create awareness, you can also raise the proper funds for more research and better medicine, and everything from getting everyone to understand that we are looking for a cure ultimately. So it's everything from clinical trials to so many things that when you teach people and allow them to be aware about lupus, it helps further that mission. I believe the public can do a few things to raise awareness. Obviously, the more research you can learn about lupus online. But then at the same time, it's events like this, like the walks and different things that you can continue to support, whether virally or in your own communities. The beauty of being a part of any kind of community is the where you feel like you're not alone, obviously, and you have someone that's there for you. But when you can see several people going through the same thing that you're going, it's inspiring, it's uplifting, and if anything, it's encouraging. So the more people that can stand up and say, I have lupus, or I'm in the fight with you, it just makes you feel like you can go one day stronger.
I got a condo in Manhattan. Baby girl, what's happening? You and your elves invited. So gonna get to clapping. Go pop a phone pad. Pop it for me, turn around and drop it for a plan. Drop it for me. I'll rent some beach house in Miami. Wake up with no jammies. Lobster tail for dinner. Julio served that scampi. You got it if you want it. Got it if you want it. Said you got it if you want it. Take my wallet if you want it now. Jump in the Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want,
just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby. You deserve it all. For you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Sex by the fire at night. Silk sheets and diamonds, all white. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. I'm talking trips to Puerto Rico. Say the word and we go. You can be my flica. Girl, I'll be a flico, mamacita. I would never make a promise that I can't keep. Promise that your smile ain't gonna never leave. Sharpest breeze in Paris, everything 24 carats. Take a look in that mirror. Now tell me who's the fairest? Is it you?
Is it you?
Is it me?
Is it me?
Say it's us.
Say it's us.
And I'll agree, baby. Jump in the Cadillac,
girl. Let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want,
just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I am LaRouza Rose. And thank you, Ron Alexander, for having me on the show for like the 18th time. I appreciate it. This Tuesday, I'll be having a concert. My first concert here in the Village. I would love for everyone to come if you have time. Follow me on Facebook, LeRuzLaRose, so that you can get all the information. Thank you so much.
Especially in Iraq and Afghanistan, have brought the realities of war into our daily lives. These images include injured servicemen and women, many with limb loss. The 2013 Boston Marathon bomb blast brought it even closer to home, injuring 262 people, 16 of them suffering limb loss. What does it take to give limb loss victims a chance to regain their lives? Advances have been made with sophisticated new artificial limbs and specialized bracing that allows restored mobility. But how much does it cost? Is this modern technology a realistic option? Or are costs so excessive that it's out of reach for average Americans with typical health insurance plans? A new study commissioned by the Amputee Coalition, conducted by the renowned research team at Dobson DaVanzo, and funded by the American Orthotic and Prosthetic Association, examined every Medicare expense over a 4-year time period. It concludes that these new technologies are not only cost-effective for the average patient, but that in fact, mobility saves lives and money. The study examined two groups of patients. One had timely clinical intervention, receiving a needed limb or a brace, the other group did not. As a society, we already know that keeping people active and mobile is one of the best ways to provide a quality of life where people can be independent and in control of their own destiny. That's something we can all support. After all, it's doing the right thing. The analysis proved conclusively that providing needed limbs and bracing restores mobility and confirmed that mobility saves lives and money. Immobile patients have more indications of comorbid conditions, obesity, hypertension, and depression that trigger even higher total health costs. Their total costs outpace those who receive treatment and who have greatly improved mobility and independence. Report author Dr. Alan Dobson, former research director of the Medicare program, said, "Looking at all the costs and other outcomes, including use of outpatient therapy, number of falls, ER admissions, and acute hospitalizations over a 12 to 18 month time period, our study concludes that patients who received the bracing and artificial limb services experienced greater independence than patients who did not, with better or comparable health outcomes and generally lower Medicare payments." Susan Stout, interim president and CEO of the Amputee Coalition, said, "Every person who has suffered limb loss and who has received a prosthetic device appropriate for their needs knows the value of the device for them personally. This study provides nationwide data which helps to corroborate this patient experience and also points us to the need for more research regarding the value of prosthetics from both a quality of life and a financial perspective. Out of chaos and mayhem in Iraq and Afghanistan has come much of the innovation that we see around us today, proving good can come out of tragedy. This study shows we can afford to provide servicemen and women and our elderly citizens alike with the technology and care that not only save their lives, but helps them regain their independence at a lower cost. That is healthcare reform everyone can sign up to."
Shout out to 8, man. Shout out to my BM. Yeah. Rocking, you heard?
Yo, heavy up, bro. This young Jay, Paso, Cash.
Rex. Rex. They kept on saying that I wasn't gonna make it. That bet. Word around town that it's going down. Who's getting dropped from these sets? Right or wrong, fight to the death, even if there ain't none left. One option was to work my way up, like I'm from the bottom of the steps. Full rules, watch your back, your front, right side, and your left. Shouldn't be yellow diamonds on my wrist, that's why you're shorty like this. And if I ever hear you talking, he's like Swiss. They thinking I'm crazy. They thinking I'm crazy when I say this. Motherfuckers staying in the plane, it's a stain in the grass. You can hear the bitch hiss. Got a young ma in a room saying, ooh, after she heard the everything in here is going up like we had to go and use a pit. Serving out those right through the screen, just like a moving pit. Recording too black, shorty, I'm sorry. We gon' have to take a pic. Whoa, I might pull up with a I might pull up with a stick. Whoa, I might pull up with a grip. All these niggas focus.
Threats, the way we deflect is a threat. Yeah, I'm high in the whip with a check. She been on my name, I'm a vet. Now it's time for that.
already know what it is, man. It's a global moment. I don't know if we want to do it, sir. Woo! Good right there. Hey, it's a global moment. Keep the love up, man.
Shout out,
man.
What's up?
They maybe see me at the end, but I don't ever lose. Like a coach in tryouts, I like to pick and choose. Yeah. Or maybe it's not me talking, girl, it's the booze. Uh-huh. Got me feeling so old, I can't recall the news. Uh-huh. Tell me who your new favorite rapper is. Without paper and tape, I swear I'll rap the kid. Yeah. I wish I cared more, but already did. He said he's whipping out the metal, walked up to
him with a plastic edge.
So,
what up?
Don't you make that mistake, I'm not a past of this. Uh-huh. Well, let me slow it down, I just went past the fist. Mm. Nasty with the pencil, kinda like a journalist. Open me up, read my thoughts like a journalist. Mm. Just sit there, let it sink in. Uh-huh. Like a puzzle, my bars need a lot of thinking.
Yeah.
Especially when I'm out smoking and drinking. I'm looking at you twice like I got imperative vision. Time for no mistakes, the bar has already risen.
Uh-huh.
I gotta put my brakes, no accident in this mission. Y'all kicked it off, I'm just trying to run it back. Yeah. Even got your girl on the track, so we're roger that.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, let me welcome everybody to my hood.
Uh-huh.
We got a little bit of bad, but everything is mostly good.
Yeah.
You need to check your jacket at the door.
Why?
Cause you might see something in here that you ain't never seen before.
But in a scenario, it's an everyday thing where I come from, don't you know? Where everybody's trying to survive. So you gotta be strong if you wanna stay alive. Oh. But in a scenario, oh. I hope you take your jacket at the door. Oh. It's an everyday thing, don't you know? Oh. Oh. Oh.
Well, your mama said that life can be unfair. And that you gotta go through changes if you're going anywhere. Good things come to those who wait. And patience is the pressure that you got to cultivate.
But in a scenario, it's an everyday thing where I come from, don't you know? It's a struggle from the cradle to the grave. Now you can say what you say, but it is what it is.
Always gonna persevere, walking with purpose, sharing, cause I know that lurking there. There's a bunch of people that's evil, hide that hurt and fear. Seeing what you working with's rare, so say you working paired. Not me though, I'm shining with a certain glare. I headed to the top with my mom and pops, but the surface there. With them back window curtains clear, this person ain't curving up half a slight to that hearse repair. I gotta make
your mama it. Says the life can be unfair, but you gotta go through changes if you're going anywhere. Good things come to those who wait. And patience is a virtue that you got to cultivate.
But in another scenario, it's an everyday thing. Why I come from, don't you know? It's a struggle from the cradle to the grave. Now you can say what you say, but it is what it is.
Dog, girl, this ain't no dog. This is a dub.
A what?
A dub.
Step.
been in Philly. I've been to VA too, even had a VA boo. But she couldn't understand how I talk the way I talk. Know why I do my little dancing, why I walk the way I do. I said it's Remo, baby, I know you're digging the style. It's the home of the raver, everybody got goals in their mind. I'm so sick with the flow, yeah, I'm with the flow. And every time that I spit, man, you already know. Okay, my chicken say dog, and I say dog. I was born in Baltimore, but I got a southern drawl. Hitting you in the head with everything but the kitchen sink. Posted on the green, I'm on point, I don't need that blank. Just an all black box hat with a mug. Holla at your reefer, she said let me get on okay, club. Let's dance, slide with it, slide with it, step with it, step with it. Put your bag in it, now scratch with it, scratch with it. Slide with it, slide with it, step with it, step with it. Put your bag in it, now scratch with it, scratch with it. Slide with it, slide with it, step with it, step with it. Put your bag in it, now scratch with it, scratch with it. Slide with it, slide with it, step with it, step with it. Put your bag in it, now scratch with it, scratch with it.
I'm did it off the chain.
She keep acting phony, but that's okay, cause I'm a star anyway. When she find out, she gon' be mad.
Cause my swag, I've been between more female legs than a maxi pad. In my hood, we make every word drag, and we quick to get it poppin' like clearance sale tag. See, I'm a bad boy, and my pockets looking puffy. You mom type women don't feel you can touch me. All that small talk, I lead that to the midgets. Now the girls on my accent, cause my style is ballistic.
Y'all say dog, and we say good. Y'all say frog, and we say frug.
Been in the hospital well over 300 times.
My hair has fallen out. I've had open sores. I've been blinded.
Kidney failure, 4 grand mal seizures, a stroke, lost the inability to walk.
I had avascular necrosis diagnosed in my left hip last May and underwent a total hip replacement on my 23rd birthday.
I went to stage 4 kidney failure and I had to learn how to walk all over again.
I've lost my hair, I've been on pulse steroids, the chemo.
Lupus is an invisible beast.
Lupus is an attack against my own body.
Every pain that you can possibly feel all at once.
Lupus, in a word, is frustrating.
It's like the weather, it's unpredictable. You never know when you're gonna have a flare up.
I don't know what the future holds for me with lupus. I don't know what it's gonna attack next.
It does affect your organs, it affects your finances, it affects your body.
I lost my career, I lost my marriage.
I went into the ER again and didn't get to leave until 86 days later.
People need to know that it's here, it's real, people have it, people you know have it.
We're surviving with this disease, and I feel like we're conquering it as well, and we just don't have enough people that are speaking out there about it.
I have hope that someone's going to see this and know that they're not alone.
And I just know that there are better days ahead.
There is hope. We just have to get involved. I haven't given up.